An extra $1,000 could be on the way for millions of Australians as part of a pre-election tax sweetener from the Morrison government. But the modelling behind its net zero climate policy has been widely panned as the Glasgow Climate Summit failed to meet its deadline of securing commitments from governments to reduce emissions.
Setting fire to the world, a metaphor, as climate activists turned Glasgow streets red with anger and others handed Australia an award, the colossal fossil.
The people in there have failed us.
After 2 weeks of dire warnings,
the doomsday device is real.
COP26 passed its deadline, a second draft of a proposed agreement for almost 200 countries, watered down with a request, not an urge, to revisit cutting emissions harder by 2030. Island nations at greater risk from rising sea levels pleaded for bigger nations to do more.
Glasgow must be the defining moment. We must not fail.
A global consensus was always a big challenge, with China and Russia not on board. Any agreement could be watered down further overnight, potentially scrapping the phrase fossil fuels altogether. There's now concern what was hoped to be a fruitful summit may turn out to be fruitless.
Without these concrete steps, our targets will be utterly meaningless.
I'm afraid we risk blowing it.
Scott Morrison took his plan for net zero to Glasgow. The government's modelling behind the 2050 pledge outlined possible job increases, but no detail on job losses, no cost or impact from climate change for a plan that relies on technologies not yet invented.
I don't think you could reasonably expect anybody to predict every technological advance that will happen.
And critics have not cooled.
There's just no detail.
This government can't be trusted on climate change.
The opposition leader is yet to give voters a taste of his climate policy. Nine News understands it will be released before the end of the year, but not until after Parliament rises in 3 weeks.
That will drag this debate well into next year, when the focus will be on the election race. And with both leaders trying to convince the public they should be trusted, the government is dangling a political carrot, considering extending income tax cuts, which are due to end in June.
The low and middle income tax offset provides a maximum benefit of just over $1,000 to those who earn between $48,000 and $90,000 a year.
Australians can always bank on the fact that taxes will be lower under a Liberal National government than under a Labor government.
We would welcome any support for low and middle income earners.
And for voters, the pre-election shopping list could get longer. Jonathan Kersley, Nine News.